Our team has been working, I think, extremely hard. Are we there yet? No, but we're putting in the time and the effort. Haven't had to coach effort, and that's been one of my biggest concerns of our past teams. So playing hard, our freshmen are fitting in very well. Our upperclassmen have been great leaders. For the most part, we're healthy, and I think we're extremely excited to get on the floor and for you all to see right now where we are. If we this was a regular season game, I'd be a little nervous. So we still have a couple of weeks to get ready, and that's what the exhibition games are for. So look forward to Thursday. Yes.
You just detail, what's the difference you see in the effort level you've gotten from the players so far this year versus maybe the recent past? You said kind of it's mentioned.
Well, I think two reasons. I think we have kids that play that type of ball, that style of play hard, play aggressive, with reckless abandon. And I think secondly, our practices have been tuned up a little bit. They're a little bit more intense. Our expectations are a lot more. And we're young. We're trying to form great habits. So we've probably turned our defense up a notch and our practice intensity up a notch, and they're responding.
Holly, how much will you use the two exhibition games to set a starting lineup, player rotation? How you approach those kind of things, I guess, for the first two preseason games?
I think I don't have a starting lineup right now, so I'm going to use it obviously to our advantage to see who plays well together, who doesn't, what kind of rotation. This is something for us to throw out and put different lineups to see how we respond. And that's what I intend to do. I may, who you see Thursday start may not necessarily start Sunday or start next Friday. I'm just going to use it for, you know, we've had two scrimmages and have started two different lineups, and we're kind of getting maybe a little bit of a core, but still not there quite to make the decision of who's going to start and who isn't.
From Channel 10, you say you don't have to coach effort. How big of a difference is this large freshman class from 4 years ago when you had seven of them in? Is there a difference in the effort that they put out and when they first got here versus having to coach that a lot 4 years ago?
Well, I think, Chris, I think the leadership that we've had right now, Tabor Spaney and Kamiko Williams, has been big for us. They understand that our practices needed to change. And it has been different because you take five freshmen, and we've had to do a lot of going slow, a lot of teaching. And we tried not to get real ahead of the game. And I think 4 years ago, we didn't take it as slow as we probably should have. So we're making sure we're getting certain things, fundamental things down, and then we're trying to move on. But how hard they play and what we expect of them, I think they have a clear vision of how we want them to play and where we need to go. So we just hadn't cut them any slack. I think it's been in a positive way for them to respond and how they're performing right now.
Holly, you say you hadn't cut them any slack. It seems like the last couple of years with Coach Summon in charge, you didn't cut the players any slack then either. But did they didn't seem to respond no matter what you did. Is that what you're saying?
I think so, John. I'm not saying that we were easy on them the last couple of years. I'm just saying we're putting it out there, and these young ladies are responding. That's a great comment. They're responding and understanding what style we want to play. And I think after 4 years, look, the group we had the last 4 years, phenomenal. I mean, we got three players drafted, two in the WNBA in the first round. So the talent was there. I just thought at times we weren't consistent, but incredible talent. Huge to replace, and we lost five starters. But we're trying to build a foundation for this year and years to come. So at times I thought last year's team just didn't play as hard as they could. And so this year's team, we're trying to make sure they understand we can't be up and down. We've got to understand where what we're doing. Intensity level has to be there. And that's the only way this team's going to be successful.
Holly, with that in mind, could you talk about how important the veteran players you do have on this team then are to what you're going to be able to do this season?
Well, Dan, I think the veterans have really stepped up and been great leaders. I look at Sierra Burdick and what she did this summer. Her commitment in the gym was incredible. And I think the young ladies, our freshmen that were here this summer, saw that. I think Tabor Spaney she's always been a huge leader for us on and off the court. And I ask Ariel Massengale, she's going to have to step up a little bit more and be more vocal. And I think she's accepted that challenge and has been an outstanding for us. So it is key. It's key for our veterans to lead give them a blueprint of how we want things done, and it's up to them to help us get there. Because it's not about the freshmen. It's not about, you know, we're majority freshmen and sophomores. And so we've got to have some kind of people who have been here to understand what our expectations are and where we need to go. And I'll say this, Megan Simmons has been just been phenomenal. I mean, I know she's been such a great offensive scorer, but she has made a huge commitment on the defensive end, and hopefully you'll see that as well. So we have kids that are I don't want to say buying to the system, because the system really isn't that much different, but we've got kids on board. And that's makes a huge difference and a huge influence for these young kids coming in.
Holly, the top 20 preseason rankings came out, and you guys were number 20. And I can understand with the loss of players last year and the coaching transition, but do you not think that there's some value in what the Lady Vols have done and traditionally shown in the past that would have carried this team to a little bit higher ranking than number 20 nationally going in this year?
Well, you have that opinion, and so do I, but I don't think the national media has that opinion. I do. For us, I think it's low, but it is what it is. And we're not there, but all I'm telling you is that is serving as a motivation for us. And I don't know if that's you lose five starters, you lose the winningest coach in the country, and I understand that expectations for a lot of people will be lowered, but they're not lowered for me. They're not lowered for this program, not these fans. And so, yeah, we don't like being ranked 20th, but it's preseason, and we're using it as a motivation factor. It's a great question.
Brooke Smith, Tennessee Journalist. As you've been transitioning into this new role, what elements of Pat Summitt's leadership and coaching do you want to continue with? And likewise, is there anything that you plan on changing or a new direction that you plan on going?
Well, I want to make sure that we understand the importance of since I've been here, we've stressed defense, rebounding, quick tempo. So that's been what Pat's philosophy is, and that's been what mine is. And as far as Pat, my expectations haven't changed. I mean, we're still going to class. We're still going to graduate kids. So that foundation has not changed. My expectation is they play 100% on the court, and I know that was Pat's as well. I think probably the difference is our style of coaching. I don't have a stare, but I'm probably a little bit more active on the sideline. I don't know if that's good or bad. I haven't coached a game yet, but I'm going to do what I think is best for these young ladies. And if I see my game plan isn't working, I'm okay to change it and say, well, we got to change direction. Right now, I love our tempo, I love our pressure, and I love the fast pace. And that's what I've always enjoyed coaching, and that's how if I can remember back then, that's how I like to play. But if it's not working, I'm not stubborn enough to make a change.
You talked about leadership, and Tabor is someone who comes off as a natural leader, and Megan has that natural leadership about her. For Kimiko, she's kind of everyone's friend and fun-loving.
Right.
Was leadership something that you had to teach her, and how has that grown in the last couple of years in her?
Well, I think it's a work in progress, so we're still teaching and learning. Kimiko is a fun-loving kid, and our players, young players, are attracted to her. And I just had a meeting with her today and said that my expectation, she's not a Tabor Spaney, I understand that. But as long as she leads our kids in a positive way, doesn't distract them, doesn't say, well, you know, the coach is crazy. I said, what a great leader understands that the coach is, you the coach is right. Bottom line, the coach is right. And then you have a problem, you go back in the room and talk about it. But I can't have, you know, Kimiko voicing her opinion. Not that she does, but we're trying to lay the groundwork for her, because her work ethic is, as I told her, has got to get better, because she's an example and people look up to her. So we've really worked on how she plays in practice, how she handles herself off the court, and it is a work in progress. And I think she's bought in. She's willing to help because she understands. I mean, she's a senior, so she understands that if she does, as she may not want to be a leader, it's one of those, you may not want to be a role model, but you are. And so I think that's the role Kimiko's been in, and so far she's been very helpful.
Well, in Tennessee, this is arguably one of the two programs in college basketball that's been synonymous with the sport the last couple of decades. Having been from here, having played here, having coached here, how much of a personal responsibility do you feel to kind of maintain the Tennessee brand and what it's established in the last?
Well, when you're a part of it and have been here, as you said, I grew up here. I was a part of her starting off coaching, and it is personal, and of something I've always wanted to do. I've been involved with this program for 28 years as an assistant coach, and I think people. I can't tell you how many questions have been asked. You're crazy to follow Pat. Well, I don't. You have so much pressure. I don't see it as that. I was taught by the best to be put in this position, so I think I'm prepared. Make mistakes along the way, absolutely. But as long as I keep learning from them, and Pat and I've talked about this for a long time, and she's put me in situations where I've been in difficult situations. I've been able to sit back and watch her perform. So I mean, this is where I always wanted to be. So I've never said, well, I'm scared to do this. I don't want to do this. I love the challenge, and I love the opportunity to be here. It's in my blood. It's what I've only know. And I think the country in women's basketball would be shocked if I didn't have on orange and white. They would think something was wrong with me or somebody, I'm sick or something. So it's just who I am and what I think I was chosen to do.
It's basically healthy. Tabor Spaney, the knee injury, sprain, or whatever it was, it seemed to go on and on last year. Is there a concern that she's always going, is this a chronic issue, that this is something she's always going to have to deal with?
I think it's, with Tabor, it has been a concern out of past injuries and just bad luck. But she looks good right now. I try to limit her minutes a little bit just because of her knee and her shoulder and the things that she has dealt with. But right now I feel great about her. I feel positive about her. We need her on the floor, not only for her leadership, but her ability to shoot the long ball three. So right now, John, I feel good about her.